Good morning, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姊妹们，早安。
It looks, this is now 6 months into the pandemic, and we're meeting this way.
我们已经开始这疫情开始，我们这样子聚集已经有六个月了。
I don't know about many of you, but I remember that I actually started working at home in the first week in March.
我不知道你们怎样，但是我记得我第一个星期开始在家里工作是三月的第一周。
And you know, with all these things that happen, and as busy as we are, we encounter all these things that happen.That make us lose sight of time.
我想，对我们来讲，我们这么忙的生活，这样子事情发生时的我们，好像生活特别的没有头绪。
I have to look at the calendar almost every day to see what day it was actually.
事实上呢，我需要每一天都来看一下我的日历，看看今天是什么时候，是星期几。
And I always laugh when I think about this time of the year when our brother Owen would order the church calendar.
每一次我想到说这个时候每一年的这个时候都是欧文弟兄他要为教会定这个日历的时候我就会想要笑。
And every time I he orders his calendar, I think to myself, I say, when do we ever use paper calendar like these anymore?
每一次当他要为教会订阅这个日历的时候，我都会笑说：“现在这什么年代，我们还在用这种纸质的这种日历吗？”
And we use a calendar, you know, in the bottom right hand of our computer, there's always a clock there with the dates and the time.
我们总是用我们电脑这个右下角上面的这样子一个日历，上面有时间，有日期。
And we flip open our phones, the first thing shows up is the time and the end of the day.
当我们打开我们的手机，也是一开始就是我们每一天的日程安排。
But sitting at home, trying to be safe from this infection, now this thing starts to be difficult to use. These technology stuff starts to be difficult to use.
然而当我们现在为了躲避这个疫情我们都在待在家里的时候这些电脑这些手机上面的日程好像就不那么方便了。
And every day I sit at my desk at home, I have a small computer like this, okay?
所以每一天呢我坐在家里面的办公桌上面这个桌子上面就有这么大小的一个电脑。
And I sit about maybe 3 feet away from it and sometimes looking down at the right hand corner,I don't know about you, I'm getting older, so I can't really see the small dates and time on there.
当我坐在那里离这电脑有30远然后我抬头去看我低头去看这个电脑上面右下角的日历的时候我不知道你如何但是也许我已经年纪大了视力不太那么清楚我不太能够看见这上面那么小的日期。
So,This year, I probably make use of Owen's calendar that he ordered, the calendar they order a lot more.
那所以呢，这一年我更加的是习惯于欧文弟兄他所订了这些纸质的这些大的日历。
I think the brothers are very concerned for all of you when we ourselves experience things like that.
那我想弟兄们都非常的关心当我们遇到这样的事。
And we've been talking almost every month about opening up the church.
我们每一个月都会有商量到我们是不是要把教会重新打开。
But it is, we have to do it very carefully and we have to make sure it is safe for everyone.
但是呢我们需要非常的小心确保对于每个人都是安全的。
Because we've been in this thing so long that we kind of not get the feeling of how dangerous this pandemic is.
因为也许我们已经在这疫情当中时间已经太长了我们开始渐渐地忘记它是多么的危险。
That people start going out to places, they go to restaurants, they go to their social gathering, and, you know, and the numbers of infection,the percentage-wise, is trending downward, it's falling, it's getting less and less. We kind of lose sight of the danger of this.
大家开始渐渐地回归到原来的生活，我们开始要去我们从前去的地方，我们会去餐馆，我们会一起跟朋友们聚集。因为这个被感染的人数越来越低的时候，我们开始慢慢忘记了这是多么危险的一件事。
And you know, it is very normal for us to react like that because lots of people do that. In many countries now, if you look, that in Europe, the trend is starting to swing upward again with this pandemic.
那我想我们有这样子的反应是很正常的，许多人都有这样子的反应。如果你去看全球，特别是全球其他的国家，他们的情形也是如此。就比如在欧洲，他们的这感染人数渐渐有上升的趋势。
And so with the infection starting, the pandemic start to trend upward, and we in the United States barely have gotten out of it, or to getting barely out of the first wave of this, we start to opening up again.
当这个被感染的人数这个趋势开始渐渐上升的时候，我们在美国，我们仍然没有度过疫情的第一阶段。的时候，我们就开始很急速的，我们就开始要重启所有的东西。
Our prayers for you is that you stay safe.
我对你们的祷告呢，是说愿意你们都能够平安。
And that the brothers are wanting to open up, but we do want to be safe.
弟兄们确实非常希望能够把教会重新的开放，然后我们希望我们能够确保大家都是平安的。
So please remember this matter in your prayer. This is not just the decisions of the responsible brothers. This is a prayer consideration of the entire church family.
所以请弟兄姊妹能够为这件事情来祷告，这不仅仅是负责弟兄们的一个决定，也是全教会应该为此祷告的一件事。
And we have to be very careful because we seem to see a lot of church in our local areas seem to be opening up.
我们真的是要为这件事情我们要非常的小心。我们可以看见在我们周围本地的教会有很多他们已经有重开的。
And I've talked to some of the brothers in the West Coast, the brothers in Seattle, Washington, in LA, in Houston, even up in New York. They're telling me that they still haven't opened up yet either.
我有跟西岸的很多弟兄姊妹们有交谈过，例如在西雅图、在洛杉矶、在休斯顿，还有甚至在纽约的这些弟兄们，他们说他们在那边的聚会仍然没有重新开放。
So we do want to gather together. It's very important, and we do miss one another so badly.
事实上呢，我们确实是需要和弟兄姊妹聚在一起，我们都非常的想念大家。
And I hope that you have stayed on top of seeking and following after the Lord.
那我也希望大家仍然的是在那里寻求，也在跟随我们的主。
I don't know about you, but oftentimes we are getting to the point where we have. For those of us who don't have small children at home, we are getting a lot of stuff caught up, and maybe we have a little bit more time.
那我不知道你如何，但是呢，对于我们这一种家里没有小小孩的这样子的家庭，我们当我们要待在家里的时候，我们发现自己空余的时间变多了。
And so it is possible for us now.To get to some of our readings of God's word and a little bit more prayer time and a little bit more reading of good books that are out there.
所以呢，我们会有更多的时间可以来读神的话，可以祷告，然后来读一些好的属灵书籍。
And this is the way we do our best in trying to stay in fellowship with the Lord.
这是我们可以借着这些的事情，我们可以与主有好的交通。
We do have the time now.
我们现在确实是有时间的。
Whether you have a lot of family responsibility, whether you have little, you still have a lot more time.
不管你是家里还有很多的责任，你还有小小孩在家里面，跟从前相比，我们都有更多的时间。
Our prayer is that you will take the opportunity to strengthen yourself in the Lord and build up that armor that the Lord wants you to have.
所以我们的祷告都是愿意我们能够在主里面刚强，我们也能够把主给我们的这个军装，我们让它能够建造的更加的结实。
In spite of the fact that we are staying at home, we are still soldiers of the Lord.
因为尽管我们是待在家里面，我们仍然是主的精兵。
The enemies will always come after us.
仇敌他仍然会攻击我们。
And oftentimes, we will be under attack and we won't even know it.
很多时候我们被攻击都不知道。
So we need to stay not only physically safe.
所以我们不仅仅是要在身体上保持健康。
We need to be spiritually safe.
我们也需要让我们的灵里面也是刚强的。
So if you are in need, please do not hesitate to let the brothers know.
所以呢，如果你有什么需要，请不要犹豫跟弟兄们联系。
I know that the responsible brothers would like to hear from you.
我知道这些负责的弟兄们都愿意听到你们的消息。
And we make attempts to call you.
我们会想要去打电话给你。
But our hope is that you call us too.
那我所希望的就是不但我们打电话给你，你也可以给我们打电话。
And we would like to hear from you if you have anything that you want us to know or want to share with us.
所以呢，当你有什么想要跟我们分享，有什么需要的时候，我们也愿意能够听到从你那里来的消息。
So, please stay safe.
所以呢，请大家注意安全。
This morning, we are going to share with you the part of the scripture of in John chapter 14.
今天早晨，我愿意和弟兄姊妹一起来分享的经文是在约翰福音十四章。
John chapter 14, verse 1 to verse 7.
是在约翰福音第十四章第一节到第七节。
Now, I know you're tired of hearing about the pandemic, so we're going to try to stop talking about it.
我知道你们已经听这个疫情的事情已经听得太多了，所以我们今天决定不讲这个。
So hopefully that you know we may touch on it, but may not dwell too long in it.
所以呢，愿意我们今天不会太久，我们能够让大家听见神的话。
Because the pandemic is probably not the only trouble that we face every day.
因为呢，我想这个疫情应该不是我们每天生活所面对的唯一的难处。
There are more dangerous things out there than the pandemic.
在外面有许多的危险，比这个疫情更加的危险。
So I'm going to read from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 1 to 7.
所以我愿意和大家一起来读约翰福音十四章一到七节。
So the message is kind of long, so I'm going to read it in English. Anna will read it in Chinese along with me. So that let's read it together so we don't separate out the time and save a little bit of time that way.
因为这段经文比较长，所以呢，我们会中文、英文一起读，我们可以节约一点时间。
So we'll read from John chapter 14, verse 1 to 7.
所以我们会读约翰福音十四章一到七节。
So stay together, let's read it together, okay?
让我们一起来读。
Don't let your heart be troubled.
你们心里不要忧愁。
Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many homes. If it were not so, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? If I go away and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself. So that where I am, you may be also. You know the way to where I am going. Lord, Thomas said, we don't know where we're going. How can we know the way? Jesus told him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Heavenly Father, as we come into your presence, we realize that we are in distressing time.
天父，当我们来到你的同在里面的时候，我们实在是知道我们现在是在何等紧张的一个时刻。
But we know, Lord, that we can come into your presence and we know we will be secure and we will be at peace.
但是我们知道我们能够来到你的同在里面，我们就得着安全还有平安。
From our perspective, dear Lord, that we cannot see the future and everything is unclear to us.
主要从我们的眼光来看，我们不知道我们的前途，什么事情都在我们眼中都是模糊的。
But because, Lord, we can look back on your gracious and merciful hand that has overshadowed us and sustained us.
主要让我们知道你那慈爱的手一直在那里护庇我们。
And that you have protected us so far.
你一直都在保护我们。
That, dear Lord, we shall not be in fear of what may come tomorrow.
主啊，所以我们心里没有忧愁，我们也会有明天。
Thank you, dear Lord, for your gracious presence to be amidst of us in times like this.
主啊，我们实在感谢你在如此的时间，你能够与我们同在。
That we can call ourselves truly blessed.
主啊，我们好使我们都能够被称为蒙福的。
Lord, we yield the following time into your hand. We pray that you help us.
主啊，我们将下面的时间交在你的手里面，我们祈求你来帮助我们。
Of the things you want to say to us, Lord, we pray that you help us retain in our hearts.
主啊，你要向我们所说的一切话，愿意你实在能够把它们存在我们的心里。
Of anything that's displeasing to you, Lord, we pray that you will set it aside for us.
主啊，你不愿意的，你不喜悦的话，求你让我们不要听见。
Thank you, dear Lord. We wait upon you. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
主，我们实在感谢你，我们等候你。我们这样的祷告乃是奉主耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.
When Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life,"
当主耶稣说，我就是道路、真理、生命。
These are not three separate matters.
这三件事不是分开的。
Although we can separate them, we can talk about them separately, but this is an integrated set of words that the Lord Jesus put together for us so that we can truly have life in Him.
虽然这三件事情是可以分开来讲，然后这三件事情都是我们主放在一起，好让我们可以从他那里的生命。
And when with that life, we can have it with Him and with God, our Heavenly Father.
也因着这样子的生命，我们能够与主同住。
When we look at the way, the truth, and the life,
当我们来看这个道路、真理、生命的时候，
this is the very fundamental of our belief in the Lord Jesus on who He is.
这些都是我们相信我们的主他是谁这样子的一个基本的信息。
And that how we are going to the Father through the Lord Jesus Himself.
也是我们如何的借着我们的主耶稣基督他自己，我们能够来到父的面前。
It is knowing and allowing these way, the way, the truth, and the life.Make it in us that will take us home to the Heavenly Father.
因着我们知道，也使得这个道路、真理、生命可以在我们的里面成为实际，好使我们实在能够来到父的面前。
This conversation of the Lord Jesus with his disciples started with Thomas asking a question.
这一段主和他的门徒之间的对话是由多马所问的一个问题开始。
He asked the Lord Jesus, how can we know the way after the Lord Jesus tells him to believe in him?
当我们的主告诉他们说，让他们要相信他的，要信靠他的时候，多马就问他说，我们不知道这条路，我们不知道你往哪里去，怎么知道那条路呢？
And this is not such an odd question.
这其实不是一个很奇怪的问题。
Because in reality, the disciples did not understand the Lord Jesus, even though they have followed him all this time.
因为事实上呢，尽管这些门徒们已经跟随主 一段不短的时间，然后他们并不是很认识主。
And when Thomas, even someone like Thomas, who is so close to the Lord, asks that kind of question, we cannot pretend and fool ourselves thinking that we already know the answer.
就连多马跟主是这样子亲密的一个门徒，都要问这样子的问题，那我们呢，不需要假装说我们都已经明白了这些问题的答案。
When Thomas asked that question for the very first time,
当多马第一次问这个问题的时候，
when he said, Lord, how can we know the way?
他跟主说，我们怎样能够知道那条路呢？
Jesus did not answer him and saying, you know, the way is this, you know, go outside, go to the doors and go, turn right and follow this direction and eventually you get the way going. This is not how Jesus answered.
主耶稣听到多马的这个问题的时候，他没有给他一个直接的答案，说哦，你要出去开门，然后右转，然后看见很多的标志，你要怎样的走？主没有这样子的回答他的问题。
Because when the Lord Jesus said, "I am the way," He's not a map.
当我们的主说他是道路的时候，他并不是说他就是一个地图。
That you can read from the way of Lord Jesus, and then you get to where we need to go.
他不是说当你你要找这条路，你就要读主耶稣，然后呢你就读清楚知道那条路在哪里，然后你就跟着来走。
The Lord Jesus is not a road sign.
主耶稣他不是这个路标。
He was not even the road or the street or the highway.
他也不是这条路，不是我们的高速公路。
He was none of those things, but he surely was the way.
他不是这其中的任何一件，他乃就是这条道路。
Let me share something with you.
让我跟你们一起分享，有一点分享。
And it has to do with what something is and something is not.
那是关于什么是什么不是的这件事。
You all have lived in the United States.
我们都住在美国。
And you are familiar with.The judicial system or the court system in the United States.
我们都对于这里的这个法庭的制度我们都有了解。
If I ask you, where is the court in Orange County? You could say it's probably somewhere downtown in Orlando on Orange Avenue.
所以呢，如果我问你说这个 Orange County 的这个法院在哪里，你也许会告诉我说哦，就在这个 Orange Avenue 这条路上面。
So how do you get there?
那你怎么能够去到这个法院呢？
So you just get in your car, you drive down 50, when you get to Orange Avenue, turn left, head south, and eventually you come to the sign that say Orange County Court, you pull into the parking space, and you get out and go in.
所以呢，你想要去这个法院的时候，你可能就开车到50号，然后呢，你去到 Orange Avenue 这条路，你就左转向南走，然后等你看见有这样子的一个标志，写着 Orange County 的法院的时候，你就停车，然后你下车，你就走进去。
Now I don't know about you, but after living in the United States for over 30 years, I've been called many times to jury duties.
我不知道你怎样，但是呢，我在美国已经住了有超过30年了。我经常都会需要，被叫到法院里面去做这个陪审员。
And so I would go down to the courthouse. I live in Seminole County, so I go out to Lake Mary.
所以呢，因为我住在 Seminole County, 所以当我有这样子的一个陪审的这样一个责任的时候，我就会去到 Lake Mary 去。
So I drive up there, I pull into the parking lot, park my car, go into the courthouse, and then I sat in the jury pool, and wait for the judge to call me.
所以呢，我就会开车去到那里，然后把车子停在停车场，我就进去了。我进去那里，我就待在陪审团的这一堆人里面，就等待这个法官他叫我。
Now, if you have served in the jury, if you have served on jury duty, you know that you have to be there at 8 o'clock in the morning.
那如果你曾经有做过这样子的一个陪审员的话呢，你就知道你需要在早上8点钟的时候就到那里。
So I would go in at 8 o'clock. I would sit down.And I wait in the jury room.
所以呢，我会8点钟到那里，然后我们就坐在那里等。
They tell you to bring your laptop. They tell you to bring a book because they don't know when they're gonna call you.
他会告诉你说，你可以把你的电脑带上，可以带本书，因为他不知道什么时候他会叫你。
Because I have to take time from work, so I take my laptop with me and I work while I wait for them.
所以呢，因为我还要工作，所以呢，我就会把我电脑带上，然后边工作边等。
And at 5 o'clock, the deputy sheriff came in, and he said, "You guys can go home now."
哦，然后等到下午5点钟的时候，工作人员就进来告诉我们说，哦，现在你们可以回家了。
And I said, "Really?"
然后我说，真的吗
？I said, "We've been here 8 hours already."
我们已经在这里待了8小时了吗
？And he walked out, and I walked out to my car and said, I have wasted a whole day in court today.
当我当我走路到停车场进到车子的时候，我真的是觉得啊，我已经为此浪费了一天的时间。
But you see, that's not a true statement, is it?
但是你会看见这不是一个正常的情形，对不对
？Although many people say it, that is not the truth because I wasn't in court all day.
因为有些人就说，其实不是真的，因为我没有一天都在法院里面。
I was sitting in a building.
我确实，我坐在一个建筑物里面。
Because what we don't understand is this: is that we think that going to the courthouse is going to court.
因为我们可能想说，我要去法院，就是我要进到这个庭审里面。
But we are not in court because the judge wasn't there.
但是呢，我们并没有真正的在这个庭审里面，因为这个法官没有在。
And court only exists when the judge is there.
但是这个庭审真正发生的地方是只有当法官在的时候，它才是真正的庭审。
Maybe let me make it clear to you what I'm trying to say here, okay?
让我能够把我想要说的更加清楚。
Because if the judge is not there, the courthouse is just a building.
因为呢，如果法官不在那里，那这一个法院它只是一栋楼。
But if the judge is there, then it's a court.
然而呢，当法官在的时候，那就是真正的法庭。
When the judge sits in the toilet and holds court, the toilet becomes the court.
当这个法官他坐在这个卫生间里的时候，他那里就成为法庭。
And if he decides to hold court in a street,The street become a court.
如果他想要把他决定要把这个庭审放在街上的时候，这条街就成为了这个法庭。
If he wants to hold court in your kitchen become the court.
如果他决定要在你家的厨房里面庭审的话，那你家的厨房就成为了这个法庭。
I am trying to tell you is this is that.We come to know about Lord Jesus as the way, the truth, and the life, but we really have no idea what he really meant by that.
我想说的是，当我们听到说我们的主耶稣说他就是道路、真理、生命，但是我们其实并不明白他说的这个是什么意思。
Because we just think that when we follow Jesus, then we are following the way and the truth and the life.
那因为我们会想说，当我们在跟随主耶稣的时候，那我们就是在跟随这个道路、真理、生命。
Don't get me wrong.
不要误解我。
You have to follow the way of Lord Jesus.
你需要跟随主的道路。
But that following is not the following that we think of normally as following.
但是呢，你想的那一种跟随，并不是我们常常所说的那一种跟随。
It's not the following of a map.
那不是跟着这条，不是跟着一个地图去走。
It is not the following of some instruction.
不是跟随一些的指示。
But rather, it is the Lord Jesus Himself that's living in us that we're following.
乃是跟随这一位住在我们里面的主，这才是我们所说的跟随。
Let's talk about Brother Sue a couple weeks ago talked about the story of Jacob.
让我们来聊一下，在几个星期之前，苏弟兄跟我们分享到雅各的故事。
And you remember the story in back in Genesis chapter 28.
那个故事呢，是在创世纪28章。
That what? Let's read together, okay?
让我们一起来读一下。
In Genesis chapter 28, verse 10 to 13, it say, Jacob left Beersheba and went towards Haran, and he came to a certain place and stayed there that night. because the sun has set. Taking one of the stone of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in a place to sleep. And he dreamed, and behold, there was a ladder set up on earth, and the top of it reached heaven. And behold, the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie, I will give to you and your offspring.
创世纪28:10-13，雅各出了别示巴，向哈南走去，到了一个地方，因为太阳落了，就在那里住宿，便拾起那地方的一块石头枕在头下，在那里躺卧睡了，梦见一个梯子立在地上，梯子的头顶顶着天，有神的使者在梯子上上去下来。耶和华站在梯子以上说，我是耶和华你主亚伯拉罕的神，也是以撒的神，我要将你现在所躺卧之地赐给你和你的后裔。
So brothers and sisters, do you understand what this vision of Jacob is?
所以弟兄姊妹们，你们能够明白雅各所看见的意象是什么吗？
Because this ladder that reached down from the heavens to earth, this ladder is the Lord Jesus himself.
因为雅各所梦见的这一个梯子，它连接着天上和地下的这个梯子就是主耶稣自己。
And you, in order to get to God, you have to climb and get on this ladder.
你如果要到神那里去，你需要爬上这个梯子，接着这个梯子能够到神那里去。
And this is an important point because if you are following maps and following instructions and following things like that, you may not get there.
因为呢，如果你只是跟随一个地图或者是一些指示的话，你不一定能够到那里。
Let me explain about maps. You guys may not know about maps.
那让我来解释一下什么是地图，也许你并不知道，并不清楚地图是什么。
Because today we use GPS, this is, we don't really know what maps are anymore.
因为今天我们都用这个 GPS, 这个定位卫星定位系统，所以也许我们并不太清楚这地图是什么。
And so Stephen Covey, who is a time management guru, talks about this.
那个Stephen Covey 他是一个他曾经这样子说。
He said, if I give you a map and start your journey from some place called Sixth Street in the map.
那如果我给你一个地图，告诉你说你要从这个地图上面第六街开始你的旅程。
Now many cities in the United States have streets by numbers.
在美国很多的城市，他们的街道都是用数字命名的。
The city was designed that way so you can't get lost in it.
这个城市都是这样子设计，好让你不会走迷路。
So sometimes the even numbers of the street numbers goes east and west, and the odd number goes north and south.
所以很多时候呢，这个偶数的这个街道是从东到西，然后这个奇数的这个街道呢是从南到北。
So if you start from Sixth Street, as you walk westward, you come to Fifth Street, on the next street.
所以呢，当你从第六街开始走的话呢，你往东走，你就会碰到你下一条街遇到的就是第五街。
And I think I got my picture wrong. But anyway, okay, let's talk about this. Okay, so from Sixth Street, the next street is if you're traveling on Sixth Street, and the next street you're gonna hit at the intersection that's going north and south is Fifth Street. That's correct.
所以如果你从第六街开始，然后你往前走的话，那这个下一个南北走向的这条街就是第五街。
And if you go up Fifth Street, the next street you hit is going to be Fourth Street because that Fourth Street is parallel to Sixth Street.
那如果你在第五街上面走的话呢，你下一个会碰见的就是第四街，因为第四街就会跟第六街是平行的。
So now I give you a map and I say, here is Sixth Street, start from here, and you think you can find your way to wherever you need to go?
所以呢，如果我把一个地图给你说，你现在是在第六街开始，那你相信你可以啊，因着这个地图，你可以找到你想要去任何一个地方吗
？Maybe。
也许吧。
Maybe not。
也许不行。
And you say why? Why do you say that?
那你会说，你为什么这样说呢
？Because if I gave you a map, and you're in New York City.You're gonna assume that I give you a New York City map.
因为呢，如果我给你啊、一张地图，我告诉你说这是纽约的地图，那你拿到了，你就想哦，这就是纽约的地图。
But actually, what I gave you was a San Francisco map that's marked New York City.
那但实际上呢，我给你的是一个一张三藩市的地图，然后上面只是标志着这是纽约市的地图。
Now, as you walk down the street, you're gonna say, From 5th Street, it goes to the next intersection, should be 4th Street.
所以呢，你拿着这张地图，你说，现在我走到第五街，然后下一个路口呢，应该就会碰见第四街。
But I can guarantee you in about 10 minutes, you're going to say, what is wrong with this place?
那但是我可以保证的是说，不到十分钟，你就会想说，这是怎么回事？
And that is, that, you understand what I'm trying to tell you, right? Because even though the marking on the map says, you know, the street number, that doesn't mean that that's how the street is in a different city.
所以你应该能明白我想跟你说的是什么。虽然在这个地图上面它标志的是第五街、第四街，就是这些数字，但是呢，它并没有告诉我们说这条街具体是什么情形。
And that is why when the Lord Jesus...When he talked to Thomas, this is the first thing he said: "Believe in God and believe in me."
这也是为什么当主耶稣回答多马的问题的时候，他首先的是说：“你要信神，也要信我。”
You see, the story I'm telling you is this: is if I was there leading you to the city, you cannot go wrong.
那因为呢，如果你在那里是住在这个城市里的话，你就不会走错。
No, if I was there leading you.
如果我在那里亲自来带你走这条路的话，你就不会走错。
But if I gave you a map, you can go wrong.
但是呢，如果我只是给你一张地图，我没有亲自带你的话，你可能会走错。
What are we trying to say here?
那我们在这里具体想说的是什么呢
？What we trying to say here is this: is that too often time.When we open up the Bible, we expect the Bible to be a cookbook for us.
那很多时候，我们打开这个圣经，我们在读神的话的时候，我们都期盼说，都以为说这个圣经它只是一个菜谱。
We desperately want to follow every recipe that's in the book.
我们想说，我要跟着这上面的每一个这个菜谱呢，我要跟着它一步一步的走。
Isn't that what people do when they want to cook food and they want the best? They want to follow line by line, instruction by instruction in the cookbook so that the food will actually come out like the picture that was in the cookbook.
所以很多人呢，他们要煮菜的时候，他们就会这样子做，为了煮很好吃的这样子很好的菜，所以他们会非常的严格，跟着菜谱上面的每一条指示，一条一条的去跟随，好让他们最后的时候能够做出来跟这个菜谱上的照片一模一样的菜。
And the Bible is never a cookbook.
然而呢，圣经它跟菜谱是不一样的。
The Bible is supposed to be lively, and it's supposed to be.The life of the Lord Jesus in it.
这本圣经它是一本活的书，它乃是我们的主耶稣基督他自己。
And that is why when Thomas asked the Lord Jesus, "What is the way?" Jesus was actually dismayed by it.
所以呢，当多马他问主说，那条路在哪里的时候，我们的主心里是忧愁的。
And so when the Lord Jesus looked at Thomas and looked at Philip, and he rebuked them very gently by saying, "You have been with me all this time, and yet you don't know."
所以呢，当主看着多马，看着腓力的时候，我们的主非常温柔的来责备他们说，我与你们同在这样长久，你还不认识我吗？
Brothers and sisters, when we read the Bible,
弟兄姊妹们，当我们在读圣经的时候
，we really pray that the Holy Spirit that is in us and the Lord Jesus that's living in us reads this to us.
所以当我们读圣经的时候，我们实在是祈求说住在我们里面的圣灵，我们的主还会亲自的把他的话读给我们听。
You realize what can happen to you, right? If you just pick up the Bible and read it like a cookbook, right?
所以你可以想象你自己会是怎样的一个情形，如果你拿起圣经，把它当成跟菜谱一样的去读。
You know, I shared this joke with my wife the other day. She didn't think it was that funny, but I thought after telling her, I didn't think it was that funny either. But I thought it was rather sad.
有一天我跟我的太太在讲这一个笑话的时候，她听了，她觉得很好笑。但是当我讲完了之后，我觉得并不是那么的好笑了。
Because it dawned on me that the joke, that you know, even though it's a joke, there is a lot of truth about it.
因为呢，当我讲完这个笑话，我发现虽然这只是一个笑话，然后对我们很多人来讲，很多时候这个在我们身上确实就是这样子的可笑。
Simply because we are lacking in the discipline in the Lord.
那很简单的是因为我们没有在主里面有这样子的操练。
We lack discipline, we lack determination and perseverance in seeking the Lord in His Word.
我们在我们的里面，我们缺乏了主给我们的管教，主给我们的带领。
Our search in the Lord's Word is untrained.
我们去查考神的话的这件事上面没有很好的受训。
And it is always limited by our own upbringing and our own training.
因着我们自己的个人的关系，我们是没有很好的受训。
And when we seek after the Lord, we always box that search within our own knowledge.
我们在读神的话的时候，我们会被自己从前有的这些知识，这些已有的知识所困住。
So oftentimes, when we seek the Lord and search after the Lord, it is framed well within our own knowledge.
所以呢，当我们来寻求神，我们想要认识主的时候，我们就被我们从前已有的知识所困住。
And we are locked in our own imagination and our own thinking.
我们就困在我们自己的想象力和想法的里面。
So now, if the Lord is constrained in the box,
那如果现在我们的主他是被困在一个盒子里的
How is he going to be of any good to us?
他对我们又有什么益处呢？
But if the Lord is the one that is in us, walking us through his words.
然而如果我们的主他是住在我们的里面，他来引领我们的方向，
Then brothers and sisters, that isSomething that is without boundary and without limitation.
那么弟兄姊妹们，那这就是不会受限制，也是没有下限的。
We should always follow the Lord and expect from the Lord rather than expecting the Lord to follow us.
我们需要来跟随我们的主，而不是说期望我们的主来跟随我们。
Because if the Lord Jesus, who do not live in us, and the Holy Spirit does not open our eyes and read His words, we actually can come up with some very fascinating conclusion about what we read.
因为如果我们的主他没有住在我们里面，他没有亲自的引领我们对神的话语的认识的话，我们可能会有一些对神的话有一些很奇特的结论。
Don't get me wrong, this is not a condemnation or criticism of anyone, but rather a statement of reality.
请不要误会我，我并不是在那里评判一些人我乃是说把这个属灵的实际跟大家讲出来。
Believe me, brothers and sisters, we often take the words of the Bible out of context, more so than in context.
弟兄姊妹们，相信我，我们常常在读神的话的时候，我们都是脱离这个上下文的，我们很少能够在这上下文里面去理解神的话意思。
Because oftentimes we are actually puzzled by the consequences and the end result of what we're trying to do.
所以弟兄姊妹们，我们常常都因为我们这样子做，我们对它所产生的结果，我们非常的困惑。
The disciples of the Lord Jesus suffered the same thing.
主耶稣的门徒们也被同样的事情所困扰。
And they follow the Lord Jesus very closely.
他们是紧紧地跟随主耶稣。
They live with the Lord Jesus every day.
他们每一天都与主同住。
What does it tell us? That we, when we are close to the Lord, when we live with the Lord every day, when the Lord Jesus lives in us, something else would happen besides what we think would happen.
当我们想象，如果我们与主是非常的亲近的，而且我们每一日都与主同在，然而有一些的事情仍然是我们没有预期的会发生。
If you look at the story of the parable of the five loaves and two fish，
如果我们去看主这个五饼二鱼的这个神迹的话
，You can see that the disciples did not understand the Lord Jesus。
你不会从其中看见主的门徒们并不认识主。
But after following Jesus every day of their life for so long, how is it that they could not have figured out that Jesus was the bread of life?
然而他们已经跟随主，每天与主同住这么长的一段时间，他们怎么会还不明白，还不认识主就是那从天上降下来的粮呢？
When the Lord Jesus says, "I am the way and the truth and the life."We have to realize that the Lord Jesus wants to live in us.
当我们的主说，我就是道路、真理、生命，我们需要明白说，我们的主他愿意住在我们的里面。
We have to let the Lord Jesus live out his life in us.
我们需要让主耶稣从我们的生命里面活出来。
And that is the story of Jacob, who our brother Sue shared with us a couple weeks ago.
这也就是几个星期之前苏弟兄跟我们所分享的雅各他的这个梦。
If you remember that when Jacob came back from his uncle, he came back, he had forgotten about the promise that he made to the Lord at Bethel.
我们如果还记得的话，当雅各他从他的舅舅拉班那里回去的时候，他忘记了他曾经从跟神所立的约定。
To Bethel, like he promised, he went to live in Shechem.
所以呢，他没有回到他向神所应许的这个伯特利这个地方，而是呢，他住在了示剑。
So if you don't understand this, you need to go back and listen to Brother Sue's message and go back and read the story of Jacob.
如果你不记得的话呢，你可能需要回去再听一下苏弟兄的分享，然后再读一下创世纪里面雅各的故事。
Because we are to stop trying to find our own way through the maps and stumble our way through the darkness.
因为呢，我们这样可以使得我们不再从地图上面去找我们自己的路，而且呢，因着这样子的错误，我们落在黑暗之中。
That is why the Bible tells us about the story, and Brother Sue remind us that we must return to Bethel from our Shechem.
这也是为什么苏弟兄这样子的提醒我们，在圣经里面记载说，我们要回到伯特利，从世界离开，我们要回到伯特利。
You see, because we have at times forgotten about the Lord and the promises that we made to the Lord, and we went to live in our own Shechem, and that what the Bible here tells us that Jacob returned to Bethel, and we have to do the same.
所以呢，我们常常都是这样子的，我们忘记了我们与神的约定，我们忘记了神要我们回到伯特利，我们要按着自己的意思住在世界，我们都需要像雅各一样的离开世界回到伯特利。
So what was the joke?
那这个笑话是什么呢？
Let me tell you.
让我跟你们讲一讲。
As I actually was watching this, it came out of a movie. The guy said, his wife said to him,You need to say, let's say grace. You as the father of the house, say grace for the meal.
所以呢，这是从一个电影里面看见的。有一个妻子，她跟她的丈夫说，她说你是这个家里的主，所以呢，你要为这顿饭祝谢。
So he said, of course, this is a movie, and he doesn't know what a prayer is anyway. So he started to say, in the beginning, there was the light.
所以他因为这只是一个电影，那他不知道该怎样的祷告的，所以他就讲说，他说， 在起初的时候有光。
In the beginning there was the light, and the light was set up on a hill.
所以呢，这个光它被放在这山上。
And you know, and people put a basket over it, and the Bible tells us that we shouldn't put a basket over the light.
这个他们人呢就放了一个东西拿来，放了一个篮子罩住这个光。那虽然是圣经里面告诉我们说，我们不可以把东西不要拿东西盖住光。
And so the reason you shouldn't put a basket in there is over the light is because the basket can catch on fire.
那你把这个篮子盖住这个光的原因呢，是好使这个篮子能够着火。
And so it caught fire, and so it started burning the bush that Moses was around.
所以呢，你因为这个篮子着起来了，所以这些周围的这些灌木丛就燃起来，然后摩西就来了。
And so Moses has this burning bush that talked to him.
所以呢，就有这个荆棘的火焰能够跟摩西讲话。
You see, brothers and sisters, this is the problem with us. When we want something, know something, we open the Bible, leave it to the place where we think that we're familiar with, and then just read it, and without understanding what it really means.
所以这就是我们的问题，弟兄姊妹们。我们打开圣经，我们读到各个地方，我们都觉得非常的熟悉，然后我们没有真正的去读它里面真正的意思是什么。
And you see, when we follow the Lord Jesus, that's not how we follow the Lord Jesus.
所以你会看见，我们说我们在跟随主，但其实不是真正的跟随。
The Lord Jesus has to live in us.
我们的主耶稣他需要实实在在的活在我们的里面。
Jesus is not something that we pull out of our pocket, pull out of our cell phone, pull out of our computer and say, Lord, today I'm going to follow you.
我们的主耶稣他不是我们可以从口袋里、从手机里、从电脑里面打开，然后跟他说，哦，主，我今天要跟随你。
We had to leave our Shechem.And go back to Bethel.
我们都需要离开我们所住的世界，我们要回到伯特利。
The Lord Jesus said, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life."
我们主耶稣说，我就是道路、真理、生命。
No one comes to the Father except by me.
若不借着我，没有人能到父那里去。
So the Lord Jesus said that about the way. How is it that?The Lord Jesus linked up these three things, the way, the truth, and the life.
所以当主这样子讲的时候，主是如何把这个道路、真理、生命这三件事情连在一起呢？
Because obviously the Lord Jesus is leading us homeward to where the Father is.
但很明显的，我们的主他是带领我们往回家的路上走，要回到父那里去。
But without the way, the truth, there is no life.
然而呢，如果离开了道路和真理，就没有生命。
Because the way, the truth, and the life is all three very integrated and all rolled up in one principle of the Lord Jesus that takes us to God.
因为呢，这道路、真理、生命这三件事情是那样子的紧密联系。我们离开了任何一样，我们都不能够到父那里去。
And all these are packed up.Completely in one package in the Lord Jesus Himself.
而这三件事情都是完完全全的被压缩在一起，都在同一个人身上，就是主耶稣他自己。
We are determined to follow our own way in many cases.
在很多的时候，我们都是很固执的要走我们自己的路。
And if the way is in the Lord Jesus, so is the truth.
如果这个道路就是主自己，真理也是主自己的话。
You know, if you think about the truth.
那如果你让你思想着真理。
What is the opposite of that?
它的相反面是什么呢？
The opposite of the truth is a lie.
真理的反义词就是谎言。
And if we lose the truth and we follow a lie or live in a lie, then we're lost.
如果我们离弃了真理，我们活在我们跟随谎言的话，那我们就落在谎言之中。
This is something that we have to be very careful of, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姊妹们，这是我们需要非常小心的。
Unfortunately, as with our human nature, we are determined to follow the world and its way in utter blindness.
然而，我们很可惜，我们作为人，我们常常都是定义要跟随这个世界，我们落在世界的谎言之中。
You know, in my lifetime, I have known this matter of the truth in many stages.
在我的一生当中，我在许多的阶段，我都来学习真理的这件事。
And even though, back in my early days of life, that people when they talk about the truth.It is a little bit closer to really the truth.
当我还小的时候，当人讲到真理的时候，它比较接近真理真正的定义。
But over the years, invariably the truth become more subjective.
然而呢，这个时间过去了这么久，这个人现在谈到真理，他们可以觉得真理变得越来越主观。
And that's why sometimes you hear people say, "I'm telling you the truth. It's the absolute truth."
这也是为什么有人会这样子跟你说，哎，我现在要给你讲一个真理，这真的是一个真理。
If you really think about it, it's really, really ridiculous to say it's the absolute truth.
因为如果你仔细去思想的话，如果有个人跟你讲说，哦，这个是一个绝对的真理，你会觉得，这个真的很有意思。
Because absolute truth doesn't add anything to the truth.
因为绝对的真理并不会给真理带来任何的，不会为它增加什么。
The truth is the truth, whether and it's absolute. So to say it's the absolute truth is kind of redundant and kind of silly.
因为真理就是真理，如果你说它是绝对的真理，那其实是一个重复。
So it doesn't make sense, and yet today we hear this one, it's the absolute truth.
这个其实是没有必要说这个绝对的，然而今天我们却常常听到有人会这样子说绝对的真理。
So in what we understand about the truth today is that truth is subjective and we can actually spin it, and this is a modern term, to spin the truth. We can spin it so that it sounds like the truth.
所以呢，这个真理今天我们认为它是主观的，所以我们可以改变这个真理，好让这个真理听起来好像是成为真的真理。
Yeah, we have today in America that we have professional people that supposed to help bring the truth to us.
那今天在美国有很多的人，他们都是称为专业人士，他们应该是要把真理带给人的。
And they're called spin doctors.
然后呢，他们会被称为这个 spin doctor， 就是他们是要他们是专业人士，然后他们会把真理玩得团团转。
And they will spin they are spin doctors, and most of the time they will spin a lie into sounding like the truth.
所以呢，他们会称为这个专业人士，他们很多时候是把一个谎言包装了，然后把它装一下，让。把它当成真理推销出去。
And that is why the Lord Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the Lord Jesus is the standard for truth."
这也是为什么我们的主说我就是道路真理，因为他自己就是真理的标准。
And he doesn't spin the truth. The truth is the truth, and it's always the truth.
他并没有来包装这一个真理，他就是真理，他从来都不需要去假装什么。
Anything outside of what he said is not true, then it's a lie.
他在他所讲的话以外的都不是真理，都是谎言。
And someday we'll talk about this matter of lies, because the lies are actually the most disgusting and hated sins of God, but we won't talk about that today.
有一天也许我们会一起来分享什么是谎言，因为在神的眼中谎言是那样子的恨恶，是那样子的丑陋，然后今天我们不会来深入的探讨。
You know, God hates lies more than murder. Just to let you know that.
我让你们知道的是说神他恨恶谎言跟甚于凶杀。
But we won't continue with what we're trying to get to today. So 20 years ago.
所以呢，二十年前。
20 years ago, people voted for a president.
二十年前，如果有一个人他要选投票选总统。
They voted for a president, and later after he became the president, they found out he was guilty of adultery and sexual misconduct in his administration.
那如果有我们选了投票选了总统，然后他当上总统之后，然后我们发现他会有这个道德上面还有淫乱的问题的话。
And furthermore, he lied about it.
然后呢，更甚的就是他为了遮盖这样子的问题，他会说谎。
And nobody knows that he had lied about it, and until he was in office.
没有人知道他为此说谎，直到他当上了总统。
He was guilty of it, but he was ashamed of it because he kept quiet and silent about it.
他是有罪的，然后他也为此感到羞辱。
He knew it was wrong, and he was not proud of it.
他知道那是错误的，他不会为此而骄傲。
And so with that is the standard of 20 years ago, when people commit sins, when they realize that they did not tell the truth, they kind of very low profile and keep quiet about it.
所以呢，这是二十年前的标准。人知道他是犯罪做错事了，他会把它偷偷的藏起来。
They don't run around telling people about it. They're not proud of it.
他们不会到处的宣扬，他们不会为此觉得很骄傲。
And they do as much to hide that away as much as possible.
他们会尽量的把它遮掩起来。
Today we will vote again for that same office of president.
今天我们马上又要投票选总统。
You can look at that for yourself, how that office now has turned into in terms of the truth.
你今天可以看见这样子的一个职位，他今天如果从真理来看，他是什么样子的光景
？But that's not really something that we should be focused on.
然后这不是我们今天我们需要就是把专注在这上面。
Because the people.Are always the same. We all are sinners. We will tell lies. We will hide our lies. But in today's society, it's less of hiding it. It's more blatant in showing it.
所以我们都一样，都是罪人。我们会犯罪。我们犯罪了之后，我们会隐藏、逃避审判。然而今天的人，他们并不会那么的想要把那么避讳说起自己的罪。
So the question for us is this: is do we keep a blind eyes on lies and continue down the path for this kind of path for this country?
那但是对我们来讲说，我们今天要继续的走在这个谎言当中，使这个国家继续的在这个谎言里面行走吗
？You see, we can pretend that, you know, that these people, their lies, their all their personality, is their own private problem. But the fact of it is that is people who holds a public office has to be held.To a higher standard. This is not just necessarily a Christian standard of not lying. This is a moral and ethical standard, even in a secular world, that people should not be blatantly telling lies.
那我们今天很多人认为这只是他个人的问题，是他的隐私，我们不应该太在意。但是如果你是一个公众人物，你在这样子的一个位置上面去做的时候，那你应该是能够保持这个道德的标准，因为这不仅仅是我们基督徒的标准，这应该是一个基本的社会的道德的标准。
As Christian, we have to tear downthe superficial to see what the truth is behind everything.
作为一个基督徒，我们需要能够从谎言的背后，我们能够把它拨开，看见里面的真理。
Because in every lies, there is the hideous and disgusting truth that is hidden under the very thin veneer of what is called spin truth.
因为呢，在每一个谎言的背后，都是为了遮掩一个丑陋的真相。
And as Christian, we have better be very careful about tearing down those false, superficial truth that hides lies.
作为一个基督徒，我们都需要能够从这些被包装的谎言，这些被包装过的称为真理的东西的谎言背后，我们看见什么是它的真相。
Let me give you a very sad example.
让我给你一个非常悲惨的、可悲的这样子的一个例子。
How are we doing on time, Aaron?
Another five.
Okay. Let me give this example, and we'll try to wrap up. Okay. A mother went to corporate America. A mother.A woman who is a mother. She went to corporate America. She went to GM. She went to Marriott. She went to this big company.
Oh, 所以有一个母亲，她移民来到美国。
No. She went to the company. They went to this big company to talk to the executive.
所以有一个母亲，她来到一个公司，然后呢，她要跟这里面的负责人要跟她谈话。
She went to GM, she went to Marriott Hotel, she went to Hilton, she went to Ford, she went to all these big corporate America, big company in America.
所以呢，这个母亲她到了Ford, 到了许多的这 GM, 美国这些大的公司那里去。
And she cried to this company for help.
他就祈求这些公司能够帮助他。
So they sat down and they asked her, what was it she needed?
他们就坐下来来问他说，你需要什么呢？
So she sat down, she said to the president of this company, like Marriott, like GM, of big cars company, and a big hotel chains. And she talked to the president of this company, she said, I need your help.
所以他就跟这些的酒店业的大头，还有 GM 这些的大公司，跟他们的负责人说，我需要你们的帮助。
She said, please.
他说，请你们。
She said, please, my daughter is involved in the very ugly pornographic industry.
所以呢，我的女儿呢，现在正在一个非常的可怕的这样子一个工作当中。
You have to tell them that's okay. The president of GM and Ford and Marriott and Hilton and all these hotels, they all looked at her and said, why are you coming to us?
那这一些的巨头，这些大公司的这个负责人就跟他们说，那你为什么来找我呢？
The guy from GM, the president from GM, the president from Ford said, we're not in that business, we make cars.
这个 GM, 这 Ford 的这个负责人就说，这跟我们没有关系啊，我们只是制造车子的。
So we can help you if your daughter is involved in pornography.
我们不能够帮助你，如果你女儿有这样子的难题。
She said, you know, you guys can help, you just don't know that you're involved with it.
他说，这个母亲就说，你们可以帮助我们的，只是你们不愿意。
Because the hotel, like Marriott, like Hilton, like the Hyatt, all these well-known companies, okay, they have stocks and their stockholders are people like General Motors and Ford and other big corporations.
因为呢，就像这些大的旅店的这样子的大公司，他们的股票都是被很多的 Ford 这些大公司，这汽车制造业的大公司，他们的 负责人他们是持有的。
And the hotels that you, GM and Ford and Marriott that owns these hotels and Hilton's that own these hotels, they have this pornography on their television and in the rooms.
所以呢，他们这些你们这些汽车制造业的这些人，你们所持有的这些股票，在这些酒店里面，它的电视上面都会放这些的色情的东西。
And they sell this stuff from the room to their clients that come to the hotel.
所以呢，他们就会对于来到住在入住他们酒店房间的这些客人，他们会销售这些的产品。
You see, on the surface.It looks like GM sells car, Ford sells car, Marriott operate hotels, high-end hotel rooms.
在这表面上，好像 Ford、GM 他们都只是卖车子的，然后 Marriott 他们都是一些高端的酒店业。
And yet, if you peel back the truth about how they make millions and millions of dollars in pornography.
但是呢，如果你从看见，如果你仔细的去看，他们从这样子的行业，这样子色情的行业背后，他们是挣了许许多多的钱。
What am I telling you?
我告诉你的是什么呢
？I'm not telling you about these things. You know, to avoid staying at hotel. Sometimes you have to stay at hotel, and where else would you stay?
我在告诉你的时候，并不是说你以后就不住酒店了。
But here's the thing.
我没有说必须要住酒店。
You have to peel back the truth like this GM and Ford and corporation has to peel back the truth to know how ugly of a thing that they're doing in their corporation.
那但是我们需要从这个表面好像光鲜亮丽的这样子的一个表面上面你去看这些的汽车公司他们为此背后有何等肮脏的交易。
And it has been said.
这是非常可悲的。
And it has been said.
那有人这样子说。
That evil will flourish without any nurturing. All it takes is for people and good people and Christians today is for them to stay silent.
如果这些这些好人这些基督徒他们今天能够看得见的话，这个罪恶它就不会蓬勃的生长。
I get very emotional at this thing, brothers and sisters. I'm sorry.
弟兄姊妹们，我今天有点情绪化，非常的抱歉。
Because when I talk about these things, it's something that's very close to me.
因为当我今天分享的这些其实对我来讲是密切相关的。
And you know the thing is this is you can ask my son. I have always told him.
因为你可以问我的儿子，我常常这样跟他说。
I've always told him that you have to tell the truth, even if it kills you, even if you're at the risk of losing your life.
我总是跟他说，你不管你要付上什么样沉重的代价，甚至你会付上自己的生命的代价，你都要说真话。
And then the truth is not something subjective, not something that we can spin.
这个真理不是相对的，不是客观的，这个真理也不是需要包装的。
It's something that we just have to make sure we are telling the truth and know the truth and live the truth like the Lord Jesus lived the truth.
我们需要知道真理，我们需要把真理讲出来，我们也需要把这个真理活出来，就像我们的主一样。
Brothers and sisters, if it's not the truth, it is a lie.
弟兄姊妹们，如果不是真理的话，那就是一个谎言。
We have talked about the way, the truth. We're not finished with the truth yet. We're going to continue that, and we're going to talk about the life as well. Without the way, the truth, there is no life, and without the way, the truth, and the life, there is no way to God.
那弟兄姊妹们，今天我们已经讲到分享到道路和真理，虽然真理这一点我们并没有讲完。然而呢，如果没有道路和真理，我们就没有办法得着生命。如果没有这个生命的话，我们就不能够真正走在这条路上。
And if the Lord is willing, we will continue to talk about this.
如果主愿意的话，我们会继续的把这几点讲完。
Let us bow our hand prayer for now.
让我们现在一起祷告。
Lord, have mercy upon us.
主啊，求你怜悯我们。
Lord, when we look at our own condition and the way, on how we live and how we follow after you, Lord, we are shameful of who we are.
主啊，当我们去审查我们在你面前的光景，我们在跟随你的这个实际的情形的时候，主啊，我们实在是感到非常的羞愧。
And Lord, we are sorry that we have reduced the way, the truth, and the life down to just mere instructions.
主啊，我们实在是非常的，非常的抱歉，主啊，我们把你的道路、真理、生命这样子的教导。把它降卑成为只是一些的条文。
For the way, the truth, and the life is the total embodiment of it in the Lord Jesus.
主啊，然而这个道路、真理、生命，完完全全就是你自己的彰显。
And you tell us that the Word became life.
主啊，然而你也告诉我们说，这个道成了肉身。
And the life is in the Lord Jesus Himself.
而这生命乃是在我们的主耶稣基督的里面。
Lord, hear our prayer as we reach out to you and draw to you.
主啊，当我们向着你呼求来到你面前的时候，求你听我们的祷告。
Lord, come and live in us.
主啊，求你来住在我们的里面。
And Lord, come and make us live like you.
主啊，你来帮助我们，使我们能够活出像你自己一样。
We confess, Lord, that we cannot live the life that you have written out and instruct us to live.
主啊，我们向你承认说，我们没有办法活出像你所教导我们的，你指导我们所要活出的样子。
But Lord, you want us to live, and the only way is the Lord Jesus living in us.
主啊，但是你要我们。能够活出乃只有一条路，就是主成为我们的道路，住在我们的里面。
Lord, we pray that you live in us.
主啊，我们求你能够活在我们里面。
Help us day by day, every morning, we become less and less, and you become more and more in us.
主啊，每一天你都来帮助我们，使我们减少，使你自己加增。
And indeed, Lord, when it's all done, we will be just like you.
主啊，当这一切工作完成的时候，我们就会像你一样。
Lord, you are the way, the truth, and the life.
主啊，你就是道路、真理、生命。
We cannot go to anyone else but to you.
主啊，我们不能够寻求任何的人，我们只有来跟随你。
Lord, we confess that the words of men are limited. We cannot express this thought well.
主啊，我们向你承认说，我们人是那样子的。有限，主啊，我们不能够很好地表达我们自己的思想。
But we pray, Lord, that the Holy Spirit that is in us, and the Spirit of the Lord that is in us, light the fire in us, so that we can truly see.
主啊，我们求你的圣灵，主啊，求你那住在我们里面的圣灵，实在是在我们里面点燃我们里面的火，好让我们真的能看见。
Lord, we once again lift up ourselves and lift up the cares of our brothers and sisters into your hand.
主啊，我们再一次将我们自己，主啊，也将我们所关心的弟兄姊妹交在你的手里。
And dear Lord, we will be victorious because you are in us.
主啊，只要你在我们的里面，我们就必然得胜。
Thank you, dear Lord. We pray that you can keep these words in our hearts.
主啊，我们感谢你，我们求你把这些的话存在我们心里。
We praise you, we give you all glory and honor, and we worship you.
主啊，我们赞美你，我们将一切的尊贵、荣耀和敬拜都归给你。
In the name of Lord Jesus, we pray.
我们真的祷告乃是奉主耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.